Hi, welcome to Wellness. I am your host, Linda Lonergan, Senior Clinical Nutritionist. I'm here to show you the very best your community has to offer in health, fitness, well-being, life events, and special people. I'm joined today by the amazing, fantastic Coach Glo, gliding with Glo. Welcome.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure, pleasure to have you.
Oh, it's an honor for me that you asked me.
Absolutely. So you are a transitional life coach. How did that all begin?
I believe it really started, Linda, when I was going through my own transition. Mm-hmm. As you well know, mm-hmm. and most sure. people know, because I'm very transparent mm-hmm. about where I've been and where I am and hopefully where I'm going.
Right.
I went through some very dark chapters mm-hmm. in my life, and it wasn't until I really started to take a good look at what wasn't working for me anymore and that I had to really look inside myself,
right.
remove the mask.
Right.
And
right.
what happened to me was that I realized that I was going through a transition of my own.
Mm-hmm.
So how I felt mm-hmm. when I came out on the other side, mm-hmm. I am responsible to share that with other women and help them get over that bridge as well.
And you do it in so many different venues. I know personally I had a session with you coaching, and your experience lends itself being so wise and so on point and saying things that you don't normally hear because of your experience and your wisdom and how you approach sharing with women for personal experience. And you walk the walk and talk the talk in all areas of transition, from divorce to loss to problems with alcohol, as mm-hmm. well as any of the other drugs.
Well, I think yeah. I even mentioned to you when we met that sometimes, you know, it's I have a friend in marketing. She calls me the coach with the unique approach.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
That's Maggie Carey.
Oh, okay. That makes
and
sense.
And the reason, you know, that I feel sometimes that I'm unique is
right.
lending to what you just said.
Right.
I will say things that people are not used to
right.
hearing.
Right.
Sometimes it's not very welcoming, but again, right. as a life coach, I'm not going to tell you what you want to hear.
Right.
you know, right. I need to tell right. you what you may have to hear to mm-hmm. help you in your own transition.
Exactly.
And help you feel better about yourself.
Right.
And at my age, I don't care. I mean, whatever I'm going to say is going to come out, and I can't get fired.
No. We have a phenomenal place there. I know, just walking on the street, coming to your beautiful home where you have, meet with people, you just feel transformed. You feel that you're in a more positive environment for healing and nourishment, and just to learn from you. Just what you said to me before in terms of with dealing with children as they grow up and go on their own, two very poignant words that you don't, roots and wings. And you do that all the time. You're just spot on. You say exactly what's needed without any other extra details. And you do it in so many venues.
I don't think you can really talk about that, Linda, unless you've had the experience.
Yes,
you know,
it's true.
The only,
it's true.
It's not, I don't like to look at it so much as wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
It's, I guess experience does equal wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
But it's only because I've been there.
Mm-hmm.
And I know because of what I've experienced with my own son,
right?
When I want to be there and not knowing if he really wants me there,
right?
You know, it's all my agenda.
Sure.
And I had to work through that and realize sure. that I need to step back and give him space and have him say, like he did last week, called me up and said, what are you doing December 19th? We're going to spend the day together. I didn't ask for that, but wow, what a great holiday gift for me.
Yeah.
That my son wants to spend a day with me and sleep yeah. over.
And sleep over.
how often do you want your mom to sleep over? You know, even my daughter-in-law, like, why don't you sleep over? Which is awesome.
Well, I think one of the most wonderful things I learned from Master Network, which we're a great part of in so many different areas and meetings and all that we learn from very talented business professionals, is meeting you. You're just such a gift,
you.
And you're so wise, and you help so many. And you help so many in so many venues. I had the privilege of the gift of coming to your phenomenal retreat, which lent itself to some very important professionals, and just a day for women to relax, have phenomenal food, and learn. And it truly was such a pleasure.
Thank you. Well, yeah. I love doing those retreats. I do them mm-hmm. once a year. Mm-hmm. I do my quarterly workshops. Mm-hmm. But I like the retreat because, as you said and experienced mm-hmm. in August, mm-hmm. The retreat was called, Darling, You Are Fabulous. And it's really the transition of going right. from self-critic to self-confidence.
Right.
And I think that's what a lot of us lack.
Yeah.
You know, and I know that for me, a lot of my lack of self-confidence mm-hmm. came from my mom. Mm-hmm. And at the same time, she was my best teacher. Mm-hmm. But boy, did she let me have it when she had to. And but that's what I hung on to.
Right.
You know, and right. so that's why even getting into those dark chapters, it yeah. all started back then, which is why I love working with women, mm-hmm. especially young women. Mm-hmm. And I like working with the older women, too, because sometimes they're at the point, like, nobody loves me anymore, nobody needs me, and I have to smack them around and say, of course you need it. But even the younger women who are younger moms,
right.
I really implore to them that, you know, you are a mom and you are the first teacher that your children are going to see. Education starts at home, not mm-hmm. in the classroom. Mm-hmm. And mm-hmm. you're their role model. And any of us, anybody who's had any experience with therapy, life coaching, everything goes back to, everything starts at childhood. So as moms, it's our responsibility to make sure that, not so much that we're on stage all the time, but you are, because mm-hmm. your kids are watching you. Mm-hmm. But we also have to look at ourselves and know, I know for myself, I've said to my son, if I do anything or say anything that reminds you of my mother, smack me around, you know, and I need to change that sometimes sure. because it's sure. not really helpful. So
right.
you need to know, like, what values to continue
right.
and bring in to
right.
your families
right.
and which ones are not really working for you anymore
right.
and not feel guilty
right.
about that, because I know I went through that, Linda.
Right.
You know, some things that right. I did not want to continue that my mom taught me.
Sure.
But sure. she was an entrepreneur, and she was a great teacher for me. She mm-hmm. she really, really was.
Mm-hmm.
So
And you've worked in so many different professions. You worked corporate. You worked one-on-one with people that need tremendous support. Your group, Shattered, which you were
Unshattered,
right, that you worked part of. And I have to ask you, I hope you'll visit my grief support group for parents who have lost children. The first Tuesday of the month at Sarah's House of Health.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. Thank you for the invitation.
Absolutely, you're such a gift. Yeah. And you continually have these classes. And what is the goal of these classes? They're just so important for empowering women and making them feel like number one.
If I can reach one.
Yeah.
If I can reach one,
right.
then I've done my job. You know, and I really... when I think of legacy, I always think that I just want them to feel that they can be themselves.
Mm-hmm.
Because again, because of my experience
mm-hmm.
And what I see today happening is when they cannot be themselves and they're trying to be everything you want them to be, starting at home with the relatives, you know, the holidays are coming up. You know how many performances are going to go on Christmas Eve and Christmas Day with the relatives you haven't seen all year, and now you have to be nicey. But just being yourself, removing that mask,
right.
and
right.
It's so much work to try and be what you want me to be, and there's so much freedom. I mm-hmm. love the word freedom, because mm-hmm. once I got past what I needed to come out on that other side,
right.
what a relief.
Right.
It's just a beautiful gift, and I want to pass that on. I am compelled and feel it's my responsibility to share that and pass that on, even if it's just to one woman, because mm-hmm. then I've helped her. Mm-hmm. Not that I did it.
Right.
We did it
right.
together.
Right.
Helped her transition into the right. other side and
right.
be happy
right.
or happier.
Right.
Happier.
Are those happy spots, right? Grab on and cherish those memory moments. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You also emphasize the importance through your classes of as women, we are multitaskers in so many different areas simultaneously, all the time, running back, especially during the holiday. And you emphasize the importance of taking care of ourselves, to making ourselves number one priority in some very special, unique way. And you do that with every one of your sessions. And you specifically tailor your coaching or sessions to the person that you're speaking with. And you have a talent, because no matter how many people are in the room, you speaking to that person make them feel that they're the only person in that room. And you do it brilliantly and in such a loving and wonderful way.
Thank you, Linda. Well, I do that, you know why? Because there was a time in my life when you and I would be talking to each other and I'd see your lips moving, but I wasn't really listening to what you were saying. I'm thinking about the shopping I have to do. I have to be here, there, everywhere.
Right.
So because of my transition, it's very important for me to know that I am present for you.
And you do it very well. Do you have a favorite book, Coach Glo?
I do. You know, I recently read this book by Brené Brown, and it's called Braving the Wilderness. And part of her book, which really touched me, was on shame. And that's why I incorporated my talk at that retreat in August on shame.
Right, I remember
because
that.
The three things that came out of that was that everybody has shame. Number two, nobody wants to talk about it. But number three, the more you talk about it, the less power you give to that shame. And that book was very, very, not just touching, but it empowered me a lot, which is why I felt it was my responsibility to share that as part of my talk at the retreat.
Wonderful. And you're also in works of your own book.
Can you
give us a tiny tip of what's going to be exciting?
Yeah, I'm a wannabe author right now.
Wonderful.
I've made the decision to write the book. Right now I'm going through writer's block, but I have a title of the book. It's called A Girl from Southern Boulevard. And I have to say that out loud, and thank you for asking me that question, because you'll hold me accountable, and so will this so will this show, you know,
so
and,
I did
and the
something
viewers.
Good.
Yes, you did
good.
Something very good, good for me right now. I didn't know that question was coming. And the book is basically about my transition. So if even one woman picks up that book, even men, because you can apply it to men as well, but
you're special.
My experience has really been with women.
Yes. So we're just ready to wrap it up, and I wanted to know if you had any last-minute things you'd like to share with my viewers. I know you have something special
coming up. Two quick things. One is I am having a class on Sunday, December 30th, at my office in Bedford Hills. It is called The Queen of Everything, Becoming Fearless in 2019. And you need to RSVP quickly, because it is a very intimate circle. And the second thing I'd like to leave you with, if you don't know anything else about me or remember anything about me, I have this quote. And the quote is, I am a priority, not an option.
Love it.
I am a priority, not an option.
Love it. That's wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. Thank you so much for being
thank
here.
You. Thank you so
You're
much.
Such a pleasure, and you help so many people.
Thank you for helping me.
Oh, yeah, and it was a gift just having you on the show. Thank you.
Thank you, Linda.
When you eat well and feel well and take care of yourself, you feel great, and it's something you want to do for the rest of your life. Remember, balance is key. Be well and eat well. Have a great evening. Thank you so much, and good night.